Welcome to 7 Tools of Quality Video. After going through this video, you must be able to outline the 7 tools of quality. Ishikawa believed that most of the company's issues could be resolved using these 7 tools and can be easily taught to any member of an organization. Nowadays, many organizations are using these tools to control and assure quality. Next, let us understand these in details. Flowchart is the basic quality control tool available to analyze sequence of events. It is a visual representation of steps in a manufacturing or service process. This tool shows events that take place sequentially or in parallel. Flowcharts must reflect the actual process carried out rather than the ideal process. Such a flowchart can be created by consulting people like operators who are concerned with it. The differences between the actual and the expected process provide many ideas for improvements as they help in detecting elements that do not add value, unnecessary steps, delays, and bottlenecks. Next, let's learn advantages of flowchart. A few advantages of flowcharts are as follows. They are used to document work process flows. They help to determine bottlenecks or breakdowns in a workplace. They highlight the issues within a process. They show changes in a process, such as any improvement. They can be used to understand complex process in a simple way. They help to find relationships and dependencies between events. Now, let's discuss about cause and effect diagram in detail. These are used to identify many possible causes of a problem to find the root cause. They are called fishbone charts due to their appearance and cause and effect diagrams due to their function. They can be used in manufacturing and services industry. Next, let's see how to construct cause and effect diagram. Ishikawa diagrams find the factors that are causing an undesired effect and the factors which can lead to desired results. To create the diagram, first identify the problem and mention it as a head of the fish. Then depict the causes of the problem on the spine of the fish. These causes can be associated with 4 M's. That is, method, manpower, material, and machinery, or the 4 P's: policies, procedures, people, and plant. Once all the causes are listed, improvement plan is initiated to rectify the identified problem. Next, let's look at the advantages of cause and effect diagram. A few advantages of cause and effect diagram are: 1. It is easy to learn how to create these diagrams. 2. It engages all the participants in the process and improves teamwork. 3. It aids in finding the reasons for deviations. 4. It improves process knowledge and creates a structure for brainstorming. 5. It helps in organizing and relating causal factors. Next, let's look at scatter diagram. Scatter diagrams are used to study and identify the possible relationship between the changes observed in 2 different sets of variables. The relationship is illustrated on a Cartesian plane. Thus, scatter diagrams, also known as scattergrams, are a graphical way of representing relationship between 2 variables. If the points are together, parameters are closely related, and if they are wide, parameters indicate poor correlation. This can be depicted as shown in figure. Chart A shows a positive linear relationship as the data points are scattered in a straight line and the slope of the line is positive. Chart B shows a negative linear relationship as the data points are scattered in a straight line and the slope of the line is positive. Chart C shows a negative non-linear relationship as the data points are scattered along a curve and the slope is negative. Chart D shows no relationship as there is no apparent pattern. Further, the method of least square can be used along with scatter diagrams to find the correct relationship between variables. Now, let's look at its advantages. The advantages of scatter diagram are 1. It helps to likely causes for quality deviations. 2. It aids in understanding how various elements of the process are related and which elements should be controlled or varied to improve quality. Next, let's discuss about check sheet. After flowcharts, check sheets are another basic quality control tool. They are also known as data collection sheets and tally charts. Check sheets or checklists are used to collect data such as frequency of occurrence of a defect or event and service characteristics manually. The data can be used to create Pareto diagram, quality control chart, and histogram. This aids in finding the pattern or trend of quality issues. Check sheets are preferably used first to analyze quality problems. For example, HR department may use check sheets to track category of questions asked from employees per day. This information will help the HR department to identify improvement opportunities. The advantages of a sample check sheet are: it is non-statistical and relatively simple. It is a more reliable and formalized way to base decisions on facts. It helps to identify improvement areas directly from the check sheet or by population data from check sheet into other control tools. Next, let's discuss about Pareto charts. Pareto chart is based on Pareto law, which states that 80% of a problem is due to 20% of its causes. Thus, it depicts the relative importance of various causes of problems. It is a vertical bar chart showing the highest to the lowest frequencies relative to a measurable effect, that is, frequency, cost, and time. The chart can accommodate any number of causes like loss by part, process, material, and product family. Pareto chart is used to identify priority issues in decreasing order of importance and control the problem. Next, let's look at advantages of Pareto charts. The advantages of Pareto diagram are: 1. It helps to prioritize problems in decreasing order or importance. It highlights a few significant problems that cause most of the defects or flaws the organization should focus on. This helps the organization to use its limited resources effectively to improve quality. Next, let's discuss about control chart. Control charts, also known as run charts, were popularized by Schuhart and Deming. They are complex statistical tools used to measure movement of data over time. They help to monitor performance of process and identify the following information related to process: stability of the process, predictability of the process, cause of variation, special conditions which might require management's interference. In a control chart where the data are plotted within upper and lower limits, it means the process is consistent and under control. If the data vary, it means it is unpredictable and thus out of control. Next, let's look at advantages of the control charts. A few advantages of control chart are: 1. It can be utilized in statistical process control. 2. It can be used to forecast out-of-control status and variation in production, like deterioration in material and process characteristics. This helps in identifying and correcting the cause of variations. 3. It reduces the rate of rejection, cost of production, and inspection. Next, let's look at histogram in detail. Histograms are another graphical representation in which measurements are grouped into bars. Each bar depicts a range of values of some parameter. Thus, histograms measure frequency distribution of data by mean. If the distribution is normal, the graph is a bell-shaped curve. If the distribution is not normal, the graph can take various shapes. Next, let's summarize our learnings. The summary of the tutorial on 7 tools of quality has been put on the screen. I will pause for a few seconds to allow you to read it.